Good morning, guten Tag. Super excited today because
we are going to be driving a 1970 Ford Mustang Mach 1, fully restored, frame up. I think that's what you say. I don't know.
We are headed to an undisclosed location, one of my favorite Fords ever. So I'm definitely not going to drive this vehicle like I stole it. It's almost 50 years old. Fully restored.
Yo, yo, team!
And I'd hate to wrap it around a tree.
A bit off-road.
This thing is absolutely gorgeous. It's no secret that I'm not a huge Ford fan. I'm not opposed to Ford, but I'm not a huge fan of Ford. I drove Fords for 10 years in law enforcement, and they were always reliable and they were always good to me. However, I've just never chosen to buy one as a personal vehicle. If someone was to ask me, Vadim, if you had $50, $60, $70,000, what classic car would you buy? I would pick the Mustang Mach 1. I think that is just a timeless piece of engineering, and I absolutely love the shape, the look, and how ahead of its time it was. And without further ado, the Ford Mustang. What you think of cars, the 1970 Ford Mustang Mach 1 is a stunner. I mean, she's drop dead gorgeous. Let's take a look at the donk. La la. Have a look at that. I love the feel of the old door handles. And take a look at that steering wheel. Absolutely gorgeous.
Such a simple interior, but so perfect.
Oh, bloody love that sign. The old TikTok.
Snap of the back seat.
As much as I'd like to sit in this car all day, I'm drenched right now. So it's time to hit the frog and toad. Let's get out there and feel the breeze. How about we start her up? Ooh. Tell you what, I haven't been this hot since the old Norwegian saunas back in the 80s. Let me put my bra on again. Time to put this thing in drive and let's get out of here. This bra, I think I ordered a D cup when I'm only a B cup. Got the air going, the air actually works pretty good. This 1970 Ford Mustang Mach 1 is for cruising, and that's exactly what we're gonna do. Steering response is quite surprisingly good. Brakes, fantastic. Engine is the Ford 351. It's not the biggest engine that they produce, but it's certainly not the smallest. And the owner of this vehicle has had actually a lot of custom work done to it. New exhaust system, the headers have been done, a bigger carburetor, just a few things to help it go. Sounds bloody good to me.
Yeehaw, mate!
For an almost 50-year-old car, this thing gets up and goes really well. There's no stopping it. Gotta love that sound. Good old fashioned carbureted, naturally aspirated V8, baby. My bra keeps bloody falling off. Now, yeah, there's noises and there's rattles and there's weird sounds coming from the drivetrain, but the car handles beautifully. It feels solid. And the only really downside to this vehicle, other than it being quite loud, is that I'm not taking it home to my garage. I know this is not a modern vehicle, and it doesn't have the luxuries that a modern vehicle has. However, it's absolutely fantastic for its age. It just brings out life in you. You just feel great. I'm gonna wind the window down because why the hell not? Work those biceps. Well, she's almost home now.
Tell you what, I'm actually very sad that I had to give that car back. It was such a beautiful, beautiful vehicle. It's just something about driving an old 1970 Ford Mustang Mach 1. It just has a lot of history behind it. and it really is a bit of timeless engineering. So another great day, another beautiful Wednesday. Thankful that I got to drive the Mach 1 today. I had an absolute ball in it all day. If there's certain vehicles that you want me to get into, let me know below and I'll do my best to get into it. However, now that we have that one under our belt, we have some seriously nice cars coming up in the next month. 2018 BMW M5, 2017 Porsche Cayenne, 2015 Holden VF Commodore supercharged model, 2017 Range Rover, a massive, fully restored collection of about 25 classic cars. So don't miss it. Be sure to hit the like button and subscribe so you can stay tuned to my madness. Thanks for watching, guys. They say all good things have to come to an end, and so it was with a 1970 Ford Mustang Mach 1.